what's going on? Divisional playoff weekend is here. I am Greg Sussman, joined today by Gabe Morenci, who's going to give us his six best bets of the weekend. What's happening, Gabe?
You know what, Greg? This is my favorite weekend of the National Football League season. Despite the fact of being a Buffalo Bill fan, I still enjoy this weekend. These games are as good as they get. We've got the best teams left standing right now in the National Football League. And now they're just a couple of wins away from their lifelong dream of winning a Super Bowl.
Absolutely. The lifelong dream continues. Let's start with the first game of divisional playoff weekend. It's the San Francisco 49ers and the Minnesota Vikings. You have been all over Mike Zimmer, all over Kirk Cousins. You know the Vikings. How well do you know them this week, Gabe?
Well, I got to tell you what, Greg, looking back on the season, I'm thinking to myself, how come I've only not bet exclusively on Minnesota Viking games? Because we freaking crushed it. And in the immortal words of the Minnesota Viking quarterback, Kirk Cousins, you like that? You like that? Yeah, Kirk, I liked it a lot last week because I was on Team Kirk last week when not a lot of people believed. We heard, oh, Kirk Cousins can't win a big game, and oh, there's no way they're going to go into the Superdome, and how they're going to stop Michael Thomas with their banged-up secondary and all that other stuff. We cashed the ticket last week with Mike Zimmer and the Minnesota Vikings at amazing numbers. Now 44-18-2. Against the spread, against non-division opponents. And the last time I checked, the San Francisco 49ers might have moved stadiums and cities, but they did not move divisions. But with all that being stated, last week's win, guys, for the Minnesota Vikings on the road was their first playoff road win since 2005. And I'm hard-pressed to believe that they're actually going to do it 2 weeks in a row. Just because I bet on the Vikings last week doesn't mean I like them this week. I was a little slow to the San Francisco 49er party this year, but I clued in when I was watching the Niners play the Baltimore Ravens that, yeah, this is probably the Super Bowl. They just appear to be the best teams in football, and their records indicate this, and their seeding indicates this as well. I think it's a bad matchup for the Minnesota Vikings, another road game going out to the West Coast against the San Francisco 49ers football team whose offense is a lot better than people realize. Like, you know, we all know about Baltimore's offense. They put up 33 points a game. You know, San Francisco put up nearly 30 points a game. All right, this is an explosive San Francisco offense. They just don't really have any stars. Their star is actually their coach. And if there's a better play caller in National Football League than Kyle Shanahan, then tell me who, because I want to bet on him as well. To me, this is the difference. And as much respect as I have for Mike Zimmer, and he's a freaking ATM machine, Zimmer can't stop the inevitable of the pocket collapsing. And if you look at Kirk Cousins' numbers, and I don't want to get too detailed here. It's the playoffs, and, you know, it's really about gut feel and the eyeball test. But Kirk Cousins' numbers appear to be pretty good against the blitz and all that type of stuff under pressure. It's all check down stuff. They live and die with Dalvin Cook. I think San Francisco's going to be able to limit. You don't really stop them, but I think they're going to limit Dalvin Cook. I don't think Dalvin Cook's going to have a big day. I think they're going to limit Dalvin. They're going to force Kirk Cousins to throw it down the field and beat them. And, you know, their defense is a lot like their offense. They don't really have stars, but everybody's good, and they're extremely well coached. I think there's going to be points in this football game as well. I don't like laying chalk like this, but at this time of the year, guys, the cream rises to the top, literally and figuratively, all right? The pretenders and the contenders, I'll tell you what, man. The road to hell is paved with good intentions. It's also paved with wild card teams that look good in wild card weekend and then got tattooed the following week. Give me the San Francisco 49ers to win and cover this football game in a higher scoring game than people think. I think the number's too low at 44.5, Greg. Like the over a lot in this game. Think it's going to get there. San Francisco put up basically 30 points a game. Minnesota actually put up about 25. I think they're both going to get close to their averages, but San Francisco does more, and as good as Minnesota is, San Francisco's better. Give me the San Francisco 49ers minus the points and the over.
All over this game, all over the San Francisco 49ers, their star head coach Kyle Shanahan, Jimmy G, in his first playoff game ever. Can he get the win? Well, going to need to, and cover by 7 in order for Gabe and you guys to win the bet. If you know you're following along, take the Niners in this one. Up next on Saturday night, you get the Titans going up against the Baltimore Ravens. All week long, Gabe, I've listened to you be all about Ryan Tannehill and Derrick Henry and Mike Vrabel, this team that defeated the New England Patriots, ended arguably the dynasty there, and they continue to roll into Baltimore.
Well, Gregg, I don't know if you remember the episode of The Simpsons when Krusty had the rib witch and the rib sandwich, and somebody traded a car to Homer for the final sandwich, and he said, "Ugh, I've got buyer's remorse." After he ate it, I haven't even bet this game, and I'm worried. All right, this game has freaked me out all week long. Now, listen, if we look at the history of NFL divisional week, the favorites generally win. All right, they're 7-1 the last 2 years. You want to go back a little bit deeper, they're 9-3. You want to go a little bit deeper than that, they're 19-5. All right, think about that. Let's remember, guys, a team that played in the wild card weekend. Hasn't made it to the Super Bowl since 2012 in the Baltimore Ravens, okay? And trends change in the National Football League, but in the modern National Football League, seeding does count. But with all that being stated, so if it's 19-5 in the last 6 years, then mathematically there's usually one upset along the way, or every one of these games going to be blowouts. Now, I think Tennessee match up very, very well with the Baltimore Ravens. Baltimore played a very close game against the San Francisco 49ers earlier in the year. It was a 2017 game, and they played a very close game against the Buffalo Bills in Buffalo as well, 24-17. I think Tennessee falls into this category, except the weather is unseasonably warm right now, and it's going to be a balmy night, literally and figuratively a balmy night in Baltimore. Since Ryan Tannehill has taken over, the Tennessee Titans offense can score on anybody, all right? They're averaging 30 points a game. They're 9-2 to the over since Tannehill has taken over at the helm. I'm a little bit concerned about turnovers. I'm a little bit concerned about a lot of things. I'm concerned about Lamar Jackson. But you know what? Lamar Jackson's not the only one that can run the football playing on the field. Derrick Henry's pretty good, guys, as we told you last week, and we cashed a ticket with the Tennessee Titans. I don't like betting on wild card teams on a week-by-week basis like this when we've already cashed a ticket. But I think they're up for it. They weren't intimidated going into Foxborough to take on Belichick and Brady. And Mike Vrabel's not scared of anybody. He's a three-time Super Bowl champion. Derrick Henry can run anybody over. They've got the skill position players to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. As good as the Ravens are, I have to take the points here, Gregg. The total is climbing right now. And I think people, as they start to figure out that the weather isn't going to be a factor in this football game at all, that there will be some points put up on the board. I think it's a higher scoring game. I think Tennessee can hang around. I'm not going to tell you the Titans are going to win this game, but when we're getting 9.5 points, man, we can be down 2 touchdowns, and that back door is going to be swinging wide freaking open. Give me the Tennessee Titans plus the points and the over in this football game.
Titans have been able to hang around football games a lot over the past 3 months with Ryan Tannehill as the quarterback in Baltimore. Even though they are the heavy underdog, they're in a good spot as long as they can just be in the game. As Gabe said, the back door is wide open.
And I'll tell you what, the Tennessee Titans have been road warriors, guys. 4-0 straight up and against the spread their last 4 road tilts.
Absolutely. The points are going to be scored. Lamar Jackson can't be stopped. Neither can Derrick Henry. Get the over in on this one. Let's move over to Sunday game. And the next game up, it's the Kansas City Chiefs and the Houston Texans. Bill O'Brien gets another opportunity to screw you as you're taking the Chiefs.
It's unbelievable. Bill O'Brien, like how this guy has survived this long. Think back, guys. The Houston Texans last year were like 0-3. 0-3, 0-4. I think they were 0-3, and they were about to be 0-4. And he was literally going to get fired. But Frank Reich got all crazy late in the football game, gave the win to the Houston Texans, and then he survived. And then Bill O'Brien was called out by the owner of the team for basically underachieving for all the talent that they have. And then the owner died, and Bill O'Brien survived. And then last week, the Buffalo Bills are embarrassing the Houston Texans. And social media and Twitter and the beat writers that cover the Houston Texans are like, how much longer can this go on with Bill O'Brien? Does he get a lifetime pass? And what happens? He survives. Turn off the lights. The party's over. Every ride comes to an end, and I think this is where it comes to an end for the Houston Texans. This is another tough football game that I contemplated a lot throughout the week, and only because I had that much respect for Deshaun Watson. I'm a big Deshaun Watson fan. I think he's a good kid. I think he's a great quarterback. I'm a big D-Hop fan. I think they've got very good football players. But if I see J.J. Watt, T.J. Watt, or any other freaking Watt besides a light bulb, more than once, I'm going to freaking snap. Last week, the Titans were America's team because everybody hates the Patriots. This week, let's just be real. Kansas City is America's team because nobody needs to. I get it. J.J. Watt plays for the Houston Texans and has a brother that plays in the National Football League. All right? But with all that being stated, Andy Reid is 18-3 off of a bye. There's a lot of talk about Andy Reid and his postseason failures in the past. Fact of the matter is, he's 4-1 in the divisional rounds. His disappointments and heartbreak have come at the conference championship level and at the Super Bowl level as well. Kansas City's really starting to dial it up a notch, guys. And Mahomes, they're a little shaky earlier in the year. Mahomes gets hurt, comes back. Everything's starting to fall into place right now. The defense is playing well. The offense can do whatever they want, whenever they want to do it. I think this is a tough spot for Houston to be able to keep up. Listen, we saw the Buffalo Bills have the Houston Texans on the ropes. I think the difference is Kansas City will be able to deliver the knockout punch. Now, last week, all the games went under the number. I think there's going to be points scored this week. And a lot of smart people like the under in this football game, but it's just too low for me. I think it, you know, I think these teams will play to their averages. I think the Kansas City Chiefs are going to get into the 30s, and Houston's going to do their thing. They're going to score 21, 24 or so. So I think the game does get into the mid-50s. So I don't have a problem with the over, but we're going to lay the points with the Kansas City Chiefs, and we're going to have all kinds of money line parlays, teasers, and everything else in between. But I figured I'd give you my opinions on the games and the sides here. So we're going to lay the points with the Kansas City Chiefs. We should note the Houston Texans have never been past this stage of the playoffs before. They've never even made it to a conference championship game. They're 0-3 in divisional games. Make it 0-4. Kansas City, Baltimore seem to be on a collision course, don't they? And it's going to be a wicked matchup if we get there. I'm going to lay the points with the Kansas City Chiefs. Call me Captain Chalk this week.
Maybe Captain Chalk, but it does feel inevitable that all year long, the best two teams in the NFL have been the Kansas City Chiefs and the Baltimore Ravens. I want to see it. I know you do, too. Get in on the Chiefs, because Bill O'Brien, the Houston Texans, as Gabe mentioned, they've never been there. They won't get there this weekend. One final game on Sunday, Gabe, and I think, in my opinion, this is the toughest to call, and obviously it's the smallest spread, so that's why everyone thinks it's going to be the closest game. It's the Packers and the Seattle Seahawks. Seahawks on the road once again. Russell Wilson taking on Aaron Rodgers. A lot of people have doubted Green Bay all season long. Not you. You're taking Green Bay this week.
You know what? I haven't doubted the Green Bay Packers. I've liked this Green Bay Packer team this year. And it's funny, people think because Aaron Rodgers didn't throw for 380 yards and he didn't put up massive numbers that somehow, you know, this isn't a good Packers team. No, you know what they are? They are a team. And their strongest strength of the football team is the defense. And I don't know about you, but I think you're in a pretty good spot when Aaron Rodgers isn't even, like, the best thing about your football team. You know, they still have Devontae Adams. I'll tell you what, Aaron Jones is starting to, you know, really put it together right now. I'm a big fan of this kid and how he's running the football right now. Listen, you guys know, man, I love the Seattle Seahawks. I'm not a Seahawks fan, but I'm a big Russell Wilson fan. I think after Tom Brady's the best quarterback in the National Football League. Russell Wilson has won at Lambeau the same amount of times that the new coach of the New York Giants, Joe Judge, has smiled in his life. Never. All right? Never. Because if you smile, you're soft. And Russell Wilson, as good as he is, can only do so much. Let's be real. I liked the Seahawks last week. But I was on. I was all over Seattle. That was against Philadelphia. Philadelphia's secondary, they've got massive issues. There's no secret there. And really, they really couldn't pull away. That was a real challenge for them. Carson Wentz knocked out of the football game. You got a 72-year-old quarterback in McCown running the offense. He nearly tied that game. They nearly came back. You know what? Listen, I like Marshawn Lynch. I think he's a fun guy, but he has zero impact to this. And the announcers can chuck it up all they want and joke about how Marshawn this and Marshawn that. Trust me, the Green Bay Packers aren't losing sleep over Marshawn Lynch. It's too bad because Seattle's a dangerous football team, but losing all their running backs really was a backbreaker. They're so dependent on them. They want to run the ball so much. Seattle's play calling is shaky as well. I just can't trust the Seattle Seahawks here. And as great as Russell Wilson and Pete Carroll are, guys, they actually haven't been out of the divisional round since they blew the Super Bowl to the New England Patriots in the 2014/15 season. All right? It's tough to win consecutive games in the playoffs. It's tough to go on the road and win, and that's why we talk about wildcard team hasn't gotten to the Super Bowl since 2012. Home field matters at this time of the year. This is going to be a weird game. And don't you get the feeling that this is the game that's going to be some, like, really weird call? Think about the history of these two guys, all right? They play all the time. They've literally played, like, six times in the last 5 years or so. And for the record, Green Bay seemed to own these guys. But think about going back through the years, guys. Hasselbeck, we're gonna get the ball, and we're going to score, we're going to win. Think about that, the replacement referee game. Monday Night Football. It was these two teams. Something weird always happens. Speaking of the replacement refs, can we bring them back? Because they're better than the stooges that are calling these games right now. All right? Nevertheless, this isn't an editorial. I don't like laying points, guys. You know I'm an underdog better, but you got to think about the motivation of what the book is doing. Why the odd makers? Why are they giving you 4.5 points right now? They're basically begging you to take the Seattle Seahawks because they know the Green Bay Packers are advancing to the NFC Conference Championship game. Give me the Green Bay Packers minus the points.
The Green Bay Packers minus the points, even as much as Gabe loves Russell Wilson. Tough spot for the Seahawks to be in. You know it's going to be a quirky game. We'll see what happens on Sunday. For Gabe Morenci, I am Greg Sussman. Thanks so much for watching the FanDuel Hurry Up. Enjoy the games this weekend. Good luck. We'll see you back here next week.